In this video, we're going to introduce the main woodwind instruments that you might expect to find in an orchestra or a wind band. These are the flute, clarinet, oboe, bassoon, and the saxophone. We'll also mention the recorder, which is not used much in orchestras today, but has a long history and is still widely used in schools and in small ensembles. Woodwind instruments produce sound with something called a reed. When the player blows into a woodwind instrument, the reed causes the air inside the instrument to vibrate, which causes the sounds that we hear. Clarinets, saxophones, oboes, and bassoons have reeds made of thin slivers of wood. Clarinets and saxophones are sometimes called single reed instruments because they use a single wooden reed which is held in the mouthpiece of the instrument by a metal fastening called a ligature. Oboes and bassoons have a double reed, that is, the reed itself is made up of two thin slivers of wood and the player blows air directly through the reed into the instrument. For both single and double reed instruments, the vibrations or buzzing of the reed is what causes or creates the sound that we hear. Flutes and recorders don't have a wooden reed. In these instruments, the player blows air over a fixed edge. It's similar to the sound that is created when you blow over the top of a bottle. Woodwind instruments usually have lots of holes, sometimes covered with little pads. And when all the holes are covered, either by the player's fingers or by the pads, the instrument produces the lowest possible note it can play. When the player uncovers some of the holes, the amount of air vibrating inside the instrument changes, and this changes the pitch of the note. Recorders have existed for many hundreds of years. Until the 1700s, they were still used regularly in orchestras. However, they gradually gave way to the more modern wooden instruments like the flute and clarinet. Recorders come in all shapes and sizes, from the tiny sopranino recorder, which makes the very highest sounds, right down to the bass recorder, which plays the lowest notes. In between, the most common recorder you find these days is probably the descant model. Recorders can sound great when played together in an ensemble. Listen to a couple of examples. The flute, like the recorder, has been around for a long time. Originally, flutes were made of wood, and they didn't have all the complicated keys that you'll see on a modern flute. These were added in the 1800s to make the instrument more versatile. The flute makes a very airy, breathy sound. When it plays its lowest notes, the sound is gentle and warm, and in the upper register, the sound of the flute is much stronger. Flute players are often very good at playing fast scales and arpeggios. The flute's little brother is the piccolo. It's half the size of a flute and therefore sounds an octave higher. The tone of the piccolo is extremely shrill, a bit like a whistle. It's often used in marching bands and in orchestras where it plays the highest notes of any instrument. clarinet has been very popular in orchestras since the late 1700s. The sound of the clarinet is always described as being woody. When playing its lowest notes, the clarinet sounds soft and gentle. Its very highest notes can sound a bit screechy. As well as orchestras, clarinets are often found in wind bands and in jazz ensembles. They were popular in the big band era of the 1930s and 40s. Benny Goodman was the most famous clarinet player of that time. The most common kind of clarinet is the B-flat clarinet, which can play roughly the same range of notes as a trumpet. However, there are two other clarinets worth mentioning. The smaller E-flat clarinet is a very high instrument that has a high penetrating sound. The other is the bass clarinet, which is a much lower version of the instrument. It was famously used in the theme tune of the children's TV show Mr. Ben. Although the programme was aired in the 1970s, the theme tune is still widely known today. The bass clarinet plays the tune along with a xylophone and is later joined by a flute. Have a listen. Whereas the clarinet has a soft, fuzzy tone, the oboe is the opposite. It has one of the most pure and focused sounds of any instrument. It often plays light, lyrical tunes in the orchestra. Like the flute, it plays notes that are roughly from middle C on the piano upwards. But the oboe doesn't reach the really high notes like the flute. It's a very difficult instrument to play, but it can make a very beautiful sound. Have a listen. The bassoon is the big brother of the oboe. It has a double reed like the oboe and it makes a similar sort of sound. The bassoon, being much larger, plays much lower notes than the oboe and has a fuller tone. In its low register, the bassoon could be powerful and menacing. Its highest notes are much softer. There's a very famous bassoon solo at the beginning of a piece called The Rite of Spring by Stravinsky. To contrast this, the bassoon also features in the theme tune to the classic children's TV show Ivor the Engine. Here's what a bassoon sounds like.
Ivor the Engine. There he is, trundling along the loop line above the quarry. And there's Jones the Steam, his driver, without a care in the world.
The saxophone has a single reed, much like the clarinet. The wider tube of the saxophone gives it a rounder, even fuzzier sound that has made it especially popular amongst jazz musicians. Although the saxophone has been around since the 1800s, it made its mark in the big band era of the 1930s and 40s, playing swing music. Several different types of saxophone are still very popular. The tenor saxophone plays roughly the same pitch of notes as a trombone or euphonium. The alto saxophone is a bit smaller and therefore plays higher notes. Both of these instruments are widely used in ensembles and as solo instruments. You might also hear the very high soprano saxophone and lower members of the saxophone family, the baritone saxophone and the much more unusual bass saxophone. In a big band, you'd normally expect to find a section of four or more of these different types of saxophones alongside trumpets, trombones, drums, bass and piano. Have a listen. Just as a reminder of all those woodwind instruments, let's listen to them in the National Orchestra of Wales.
Let's meet the woodwind section, going from the lowest instrument to the highest. The contrabassoon. The bassoons. The clarinets. The oboes. The flutes. The piccolo. Together, the woodwind section sounds like this. That is the woodwind section.